In short, the skill that we're looking at is like having a crystal ball, and you see where will this person be 1 year from now, and then you say, if I make this adjustment, where will this person be 1 year from now, and then selecting the adjustments you want to make. Okay, so this is the crux of what we are here for. This is excellence installation technology. It's what adjustments to make in the first place. In his book, Turtles All the Way Down, John Grinder talks about the challenge Judith and he was facing, in that people who learn NLP almost lost all their friends, or their life were getting ruined, and they were not necessarily changing the quality of life of people. And he brings about this definition of learning a technology versus the artistry and wisdom of when to use it. So about 20 years ago, John attempted to fix that with a book called Turtles All the Way Down, which is supposedly not the NLP techniques, but on how and where to use it and where not to use it. He as a person has that wisdom. You be in his presence and you come out, things happen in your life, period. Right? So you could go to a seminar which has nothing to do with what you're doing in life, but if he knows you and he knows what you want, he probably will do something for you that will have a generative effect. Not just at that moment, a month later, 2 months later, 3 months later, and a year later. And it has been my mission to model that. To not just assimilate the skill, but also to assimilate it and arrive at a code that if someone were to learn it, they would be able to get some of the wisdom with which John is making the changes, the adjustments that leads to some fantastic consequences over time. This environment that you have over here is the perfect opportunity for you to validate it for a variety of reasons. One, people here are here giving us permission saying, hey, help us get there. Second, I'm priming them up, which means they're so open to installations that even if you hit it almost right, it will work on them, right? Because their neurology is looking for those kind of installations. Three, you can get immediate feedback. And that is why this is a 6-day program. You notice a pattern on the second and third day, you do an installation on them. On the fifth and sixth day, you know whether that installation has worked or not. Now, what does it give you feedback on? A. Remember A into T equal to C? You get a feedback on, are you able to make adjustments conversationally? You don't yet have a feedback on the consequence, but you have a guess. Now, the participant is going to come back again, right? That's why we give unlimited revisits, because I am super committed to developing this model. So when people come back again, not only do I have an opportunity to help them get to the next level, I also have the feedback mechanism to know what consequences those adjustments have really produced. Okay, so in my opinion, I have probably the intuition of which adjustments are going to make a great consequence. I wouldn't say I have coded it fully yet. It might be this year, it might be. I've given myself a deadline, 2019. I have to code it before that. But I do know that I'm able to, in this program, help you arrive at that intuition too. It may not be an explicit code, but as a way of working together, you would arrive there. So in these 6 days, you'll learn whether your adjustments are working, but when you come back again, when you come back and you keep seeing what's happening, that's when you understand the effect of those adjustments over a period of time and the consequences it is creating. Okay, so this is the crux of EIS. So if you finish EIS, it means you have developed a set of skills by which you're able to first recognize which adjustments will lead to a dramatic change in the quality of life over time. And you also have the ability to make that adjustment immediately. So what are some of the adjustments we're talking about? Yeah, so it could be overcoming a limitation, like stammering. It could be changing a behavior, like cravings. It could be habits. What else? Phobias. Yeah. Pardon me?
More options in a given situation.
To develop more choices in a given situation. Okay. There are two more classes of adjustments that we make, and those are very, very important. Okay. One is capabilities. So when we talk about superior capabilities, we are actually referring to capabilities. Okay. Not to positive thinking, not feeling happy. We are talking about capabilities. Okay. For me, there are at least 8 capabilities. Over these years of doing this again and again and again, I've arrived at a set of capabilities that I believe are absolutely essential for most people. The top of the list is disassociation. Then there is on-demand state change. Then there is the ability to filter. Then there's a perceptual positions, unconscious assimilation. So it is absolutely important that we not only fix limitations behaviorally, see, because fixing behavior limitations is easier with a pattern. Get done with it. But there are some things that are not so easy with pattern. It is possible, but it's even difficult to let them know they have to change it. It's like, one is capability. Okay, so can you do capability installation with patterns?
Yes, definitely.
How?
So let us say somebody is not modeling in a particular context.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
They are AD.
Yeah.
You play an alphabet game and they will...
They are AD. What he means is they're talking to themselves. Yeah. Like this. I should look at her. I shouldn't think. There's a voice going on inside. So this is a limitation that's coming in the way of the capability. So you could do an alphabet game, right? You could do that. What you could also do is, I have an example of a girl who was an obsessive compulsive mirrorer. Okay, so she would, after the program, when she's with somebody, if they have a boil in her hand, she will have the boil in the hand in the exact same location. Okay, and she wanted to come for the next up batch. And I told her, no, you're not coming for the next up batch until you send me a report of having done fast phobia cure on 10 people. What would that do?
Disassociation.
It installs the capability of disassociation. Why? Absolutely. So we are feeding into her own inability. We are feeding into her challenge to create a capability. What's a challenge? She can't stop herself from mirroring. So when she does fast phobia cure on someone, what is going to happen? She's going to mirror them disassociating. And when she does it on 10 people, what would happen? She's mirrored enough number of people for her to disassociate. Right? So is it possible to do installation of capabilities with patterning? Yes. And a lot of times the reason we are doing patterning with each other is for the unconscious to be primed for those capabilities. Okay? And but as EIS, that's going to be a focus. We're going to look at what capabilities have to be added to this person. And another important thing that we're going to do with adjustments. So in adjustments, we looked at behaviors, we looked at limitations, we looked at capabilities. The map, the meaning they're attaching to the world they live in. And this is the most difficult, in my opinion, to fix with a pattern. Up until now, we have most times done it only with installations, right? So let's say someone has a belief that they can't learn anything unless they spend 2 years on it. Now, that is not necessarily a very useful belief. But what is more dangerous is, how did they come to that conclusion? What are the set of processes that are going on in their head that gets them to come to such ridiculous conclusions? Changing that is going to be the most generative. Okay, so you remember the hierarchy state? Structure,
content.
State is like the anger, the irritation, the fear, the phobia, all of those things. Structure is how they process information that is coming to them. How do they decide to attach meaning to what is going on? And that particular part is, you know, it's like hypnosis. When people are attaching a particular meaning, it becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. So it will always be true to that person. It's up to us to look at that pattern and to break that pattern. Okay, so that's the most important role that we're going to be playing as EIS. A lot of times in EIS, people get obsessed with the metaphors. Metaphors are important. They are very important. It is important for the metaphors to be very precise, but more important than the metaphors. In fact, I believe that most of us have a natural ability to just say a metaphor. But more than the metaphor, the importance is coming to precision of the process. This is exactly what that person is doing that is creating that problem. And getting to that precision with sensory acuity.
The installation of these capabilities start on first day. Okay. For example, the Delhi batch videos that was put on Facebook. If you went through them, it will be very evident that for that particular batch, the installation that I was focusing on is disassociation. Okay, what was the installation that we started off for this batch?
Unconscious assimilation,
which is second position. Right, so it's completely different from what we did for in the Delhi batch. Now it started. Now whether people recognize it or not, they are going to be good modelers. And that journey is already started. Tomorrow people are going to come and some are going to exaggerate about how they're suddenly feeling emotions that they've never felt before. You will hear good emotions, you'll hear bad emotions. That is how we know that, okay, some new capability is already begun. What is the next logical installation I need to do in terms of capabilities? Absolutely. I cannot do an installation of second position and leave them without filters. And if you notice, we've already started seeing the seeds for it. Tomorrow I have to make sure that the thing is completed. Now, if you pay careful attention, you'll notice that not only were we doing the installation of these capabilities, we've also sown the seeds that they start to generalize. Okay, there were enough and sufficient metaphors right from the beginning of the day that was focused on how to generalize the learning that you are having over here. So the stories and metaphors that you're giving are not only for one particular installation, but you're able to stack it so that it happens at a multiple layer. And you recognize and understand fully the list of capabilities that are involved in what Harini and I call success for autopilot. So when you start to recognize these things more easily and spontaneously, and you are able to do that at some level, that's when I believe you're in stage three. Remember, our objective is not to make everybody a clones of who we are. We don't want to take everybody and fix everything we consider a problem and at the end of the day make everybody a clone of what we are. The fundamental assumption I work with is everybody has a perfect way of organizing their world. And there are these one or two things that are necessary for them to get the maximum of what they're doing. So the whole intuition that you're modeling is, what are those one or two things? You remember I keep talking about elegance? I don't want to change everything of a person. I want them to have their personality, their uniqueness. But I want to change the minimum necessary for them to compress time, for them to arrive at a better consequence faster and quicker. Okay, so that's the... Do you like that? Yeah. It is a very powerful technology indeed.